Brad Byers is a mind-boggling international entertainer. We visited his home in Moscow for an interview and found that he yo-yos, unicycles, and performs with household utensils. He now has the world record for swallowing 10 swords. Juggling is the act that Byers began with.
Start out as a kid in high school. I was about 15 years old, and I was never interested in sports, and started out just as a hobby one summer. And I just began juggling three balls until it grew into a complete act. I just thought it would be nice to make my living doing something that I really enjoyed, as opposed to living for the weekends like most people seem to do. Mm-hmm. My mother once told me that if ever I was going to be a professional juggler, I would have to juggle butcher knives or something, was her exact words. So I promptly went down to the hardware store and bought some butcher knives. But I knew that she would be very afraid and maybe even angry if she caught me practicing, so I hid them underneath my bed when I was a kid.
After high school, Byers traveled with the circus, but found the work was not very rewarding, so he looked for a knack that would do more than just pay the bills. He knew there were only a dozen sword swallowers in the world and decided to try it for himself. He walked into a store to find his first sword.
I did tell the clerk that I would like to test it out, try it before I bought it, because I didn't want to buy a sword that wouldn't work.
And how did he or she react to that?
Well, as I withdrew the sword, of course my head's back when I saw the sword, so I couldn't see. But as I withdrew the sword and straightened my head and looked at him, he just kind of had his mouth open. And I laid it on the counter and said, yeah, I'll take it.
Byers demonstrated sword swallowing for us. Byers helped with the production of the movie Benny and June and was told he would appear as a stunt double.
I taught Johnny Depp to spin hubcaps. Unfortunately, he's not the most coordinated person, so I had to design an extra piece to the hubcap so even he could spin them easily. I only learned this trick because it was just a request for the movie. And so I taught Johnny Depp to do all that, did the stunt doubling part, found out at the theater that they cut my stunt doubling part from the movie. I still get royalty checks, though, but unfortunately I wasn't in the movie.
Among Byers' collection of oddities are several tarantulas and scorpions, which he was happy to show us.
Both these are from Mexico and fairly rare. This species here, the red-knee tarantula, started the hobby of keeping tarantulas.
Oh, I come from a land, from a faraway place, where the caravan.
Here's a sample of Byers' unique talents.
Where they cut off your ear if they don't like your face. It's barbaric, but hey, it's home. When the wind's from the east, and the sun's from the west, and the sand in the glass is right, come on down, stop on by, hop a carpet and fly to another Arabian night. Arabian nights, like Arabian days, more often than not, are hotter than hot in a lot of good ways.
Brad presented me with a sword he thought I might be able to swallow. And then he said if I worked my way up, someday. Sandra Castle, for U of I Voices.